Today's subject is I Am Wrath, a new VOD action thriller from John Travolta. Travolta's Taken, claims a critic on the poster. Honestly, that's not even true. Travolta doesn't get taken at all in this. I don't know what movie he watched. Now, with this other poster, I don't get a Taken vibe so much as I get a Jack Reacher one. I mean, look at these posters, they're almost completely identical. This can't be a coincidence. Oh well, I just hope this lack of creative effort in the poster isn't a reflection of the quality of the movie. Well, it is. I Am Wrath is yet another movie about a retired man of violence who returns to the world of guns and gangsters when someone close to him is kidnapped or killed. In this case, it's Travolta's wife, and she's killed. This genre has been completely worn out at this point, and this movie fails to make a case for this trend to continue. It's pure formula. The people who made this have nothing to add at this point. I didn't like the very comparable Rage, but even that film threw in a somewhat clever twist ending that defied my expectations. I didn't like Stolen, but even that movie added a nice little heist angle. I didn't like Taken 3, but... Okay, this movie's not nearly as bad as Taken 3. My point is that even some of the bottom-of-the-barrel Taken knockoffs try to differentiate themselves from the pack. Even if it's just in a small way, I Am Wrath just doesn't. It's completely unoriginal and unremarkable. My first thought when I saw the trailer for this was, isn't John Travolta too old and fat to be the lead in an action movie? Having seen it, I can say that Travolta is too old and fat to be the lead in an action movie. Nothing against the guy, I mean there are action stars out there in much worse shape than he is, but he's just not very convincing in the action scenes. He can't move very fast and he doesn't hit very hard. When a bad guy goes down, you don't really buy it. The one decent fight in the film is performed by a pretty obvious stunt double. The only thing I really took away from this movie is that I really don't want to visit Columbus. This movie was filmed on location there, and wow, does it make it look like a cesspool. According to this movie, there are shootings every day, apathetic cops, corrupt politicians, and endless amounts of drug abuse. I don't want to die, so I'm going to stay out of Columbus. Thanks for the warning, I Am Wrath. I'm sure it was a completely accurate representation of Ohio life. In conclusion, if you're as tired as I am of the action grandpa genre, you can skip I Am Wrath. Narrative-wise, it's nothing you haven't seen before, and action-wise, it's quite poor. I'm giving it a 3 out of 10.